Good morning, everybody. Welcome back to Autenry Family Farm. So, pardon the noise in the background, just letting the John Deere 5400 warm up a little bit. It's about 30 degrees this morning here in northern Michigan. We got a little bit of snow, as you can see in the background. And what we're up to today is spreading this stuff. And this is chicken litter from Morgan's Composting. And we've got about 50 tons of this here, and we're spreading it with this lime spreader that we rented from the co-op here nearby. And I'm gonna try to get some action shots with this. It's definitely new. This is gonna be something that we haven't done before, so hopefully it goes okay. And we'll talk to you later. Thanks, guys.
Manure!
As you can see, I've got the air conditioning cab on tractor permanently, and that's kind of what we deal with. So anyway, I think I've got this spreader worked out now to the rate that we want to put everything on, and hopefully we'll get everything the way we want it, and everything will be nice and even. So it's gonna get loud here, I think. If it is, I'll mute it on the video, and so you guys don't have to listen to the engine and just kind of watch the show. But we'll get going here, and it comes out all right. So we're gonna turn the PTO on first, grab the engine up, and then we're gonna take off. So here we go. PTO. So the
two things that we really lack here, our soil really lacks here, is nitrogen, available nitrogen, and potassium.
A lot of potato farming going on here. That's also what this was used for since the early 60s. Before that, this place was a dairy homestead type.
Mostly organic practices here without even knowing it. Most people don't realize that
before World War II,
everything was organic. We didn't have chemical fertilizers. We didn't have glyphosate, which came out in the 90s. We didn't have Roundup. It's the same thing. Didn't need it. Some people don't understand that. Farmed organically for that. So there's some things to be said for yield, you know.
I'm not 100% convinced you can get the same yield with organic practices as you can with conventional
practices just by using your own breeding techniques. It takes some time, especially when you're starting, but you can get there.
Practice a lot of regenerative agricultural things here on this farm.
Trying to end that. Trying to do everything that we can to make this farm more sustainable. Environmentally and ecologically sustainable. Financially as well. It's getting there. This is going to be huge, I hope. This have not applied any fertilizer to this farm since we owned it in 2000. We bought it fall of 2012. It hasn't had any fertilizer on here at all. It's only had what our pasture raised beef, cattle, and chickens contribute through eating the plants and depositing their manure. That's it.
But it needs a little more.
It's so devoid of nutrients that you have to put some on, especially with how sandy and watery our soil is. We need to put on it. At least it's not organic. By organic, I just mean not petrochemical at that point. Some manures and hay, old waste hay, straw, things like that, compost. Organic sources of they're a little heavy there. The organic sources of nutrients that are we're not talking the difference between organic certified or not. We're talking about organic versus inorganic. So manure, compost, things like that are organic. Sources.
Go back to chemistry class.
Things like fossil fuel generated inputs, fertilizer,
inorganic. We're not getting down to the oil and gas industry.
We don't
discount anybody how they make a living or what they do. That's not our point. We don't think that we have the right to do that. How you make your living is your business. So, anyway, I'm going to get hooked back up here and
get the spread.
Thanks, guys.
All right, folks, that's it. Here's the last load. Chicken manure. Spread in between. Taking care of kids. Trying to do my day job and farming.
Send you all off with a candid video shot of my smoking hot fire.
Manure.
Right. We're all done. Last one. Thanks for watching, guys.